So we got a bucket full of pumps and hoses, and it was actually, the pond is lowered in the backside, so we really couldn't use a siphon, so we just brought two pumps. We're gonna pump this water out while I'm gonna rip that down a little bit lower, let that water out a little bit more, and then kind of build a cofferdam for my structure up there. And we'll build a pad out of this riprap, something solid for it to sit on. And we'll set our pumps up so the water don't rise up on it, so we can pour concrete and let it cure for a little while. So let me take that pump out, and then I'll mash a little spot down here for them to sit at. Then I'll dig a little sump hole right there and pump a little water.
As you can see, we have plenty of room to work here. Thank you.
thing's heavy. So I'll find out where the water is and then subtract 60 inches from that elevation, and that'll tell me where I need to build my pad at for that to sit on within an inch or so. It's not the end of the world if it ain't perfect. It's just a pond here, but we like to get as close as possible. Alrighty, we're gonna go ahead and try to set this structure in place. proportion of where I want it. We'll go ahead and dig our ditch for a pipe. chain so they can get the coupler on it. Need me to cut it off? Okay. the structure placed, pipe put in, dirt holding it, anti-seize collar. We're back here packing this backside, and then we will pour concrete and pack that. Got it backfilled all the way down to the pool down there where it discharges. So we got our concrete poured around there for anti-seep collar, and got all the concrete poured around here to act as a ballast so this thing won't float. And I just finished grouting the pipe in. Got that grouted in and the concrete troweled out down in there. So let that dry and go ahead and get this backfill when it dries and set the trash rack on. So go ahead and put a little dirt in here and get this covered up and try to get this dam put back in place.
There we go. They don't look heavy, but they're actually pretty heavy.
I got all this done and slicked up. We still got a little pile right here to load out, but we got all this done. The thing dredged out right here and the water's filling it back up, and I'll walk down there and show you the overflow that's done. I got all the riprap put back in place and cleaned up. I got this slicked up the best I could with the 160. They got a landscaper, they said he would handle the rest of it, finish grading it out and seeding and strawing it, so he wanted to do that. But I just got it raked around and patted down the best I could. But here is the new riser. Got the structure set, I got my rock put back around it and a trash rack set on it. So now the it's got a much bigger overflow drain in it than it did. But they said it's gone over that pipe up there and all in the road and everything. So that should handle this water. Pretty much with the bigger riser over the pipe is the water only has to come up like 4 or 5 inches on that 48 inch diameter riser pipe. And then this 24 inch pipe will be slammed full. So the pond doesn't have to fill up as much before it starts draining out as quick. So they really didn't want to do anything back here. It really needs some rock around this, but they were content with it just dumping back out into the hole that it already did. So I got the pipe tapered all the way down to the water, so hopefully it won't pour out as bad. And as you can already see it, that other pipe washed out a humongous hole, but that's what they wanted to do. So the water will drain out right there, and that's pretty much it. Got everything picked up and cleaned up. And the amount of water coming in here, this pond ought to be a full in probably a week with just the water just running back into it. Maybe I'm gonna stop back by when it's done, filled up.